nothing I can do. My channel. So as you can tell, today is a video that you guys have been requesting for like about a month now. Even before I actually moved into uni, you guys knew that I was obviously going to uni. A lot of you wanted to see this, and here we are. Here is my room tour for 2020. My room is not actually completely finished, but it is what it is now. I do apologize that it has taken this long for it to come, but I was still waiting for certain things to come, but it's okay, we move. I hope you guys do enjoy this video and obviously kind of get to see my room, my uni accommodation for 2020. I'm a first year student at Nottingham Trent University, and I'm studying architecture, and my accommodation is literally 2 minutes away from my campus, which is City Campus. So yeah, you know the vibes. If you did enjoy this video, make sure you give this video a big thumbs up. Subscribe if you're new to my channel. Please, 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 please hit the subscribe button down below, as there's going to be a giveaway at 15k. So get me there, get me to 15k. I am still working on the setup and how I want my setup to actually look like. I don't know if I'm too happy with this, but we honestly move. If you get into this video, I will put a time little thing on screen now to just basically tell you guys where you can kind of skip to the actual room tour. But this video is actually sponsored, there's an ad in it. Basically, a company sent me some free stuff, and I'm gonna show you guys the free stuff that I got sent. As you all know, I am a university student, and I am going to be depending on YouTube a lot more, and I'm gonna be 100% real and transparent with you that when this company reached out to me, I was like, I need some groceries and I don't want to pay for it, so this will be great. So this company, lovely company, I absolutely love working with them. They have been so cooperative and just been so like on the ball. Name is Cherries. I don't think you would have heard of it. Personally, I hadn't heard of it until they got in contact with me. But I've seen some of their videos and kind of watched some of their like hauls. And they basically do loads of groceries, but for cheap, like stupidly cheap. So for the discount code, I have obviously plugged you guys, and you guys can actually shop on the website and get 20% off your order. So make sure you go and leave it linked. Make sure you go. This is why I don't like, I'm a YouTuber who? YouTuber where? Make sure you go and use my discount code down below. Go and shop on the store and you can get 20% off. It is just Nana20, I believe. I'll leave it linked down below. I'll leave it on the screen. So make sure you go and shop there. If you are a uni student like me, if you've just moved into uni and you want to kind of get cheap or like basic necessities, I got you. So yeah, I'm just going to show you some of the bits that I got. I say some. There are two huge boxes. This is so much. Okay. Stuff is in here. I'm actually so excited. You don't understand how like buying cleaning products now is what gives me joy. Like adulting is real. I got myself like a basically, is that focused? Yeah, it is. Basically, it's like a chip holder. Me, I'm coming to do presentation. I'm coming to be Chef Gordon Ramsay when my friends come over. So I'm gonna put chips in there, serve it with some steak on the side, some salad. Yeah, I got this, whatever this is. I know it's for like when you're serving tongs. There we go. Some bin bags, because what I tell you, I feel like I'm getting robbed when I have to buy these stupid things. So I've got some bin bags. I think I've got quite a few of these. There is another one of the little chips thing. I got some combs, because why not? When do you not need combs? I mean, I have faulty hair, so like I always need combs just to like part my hair and stuff like that. My hair's actually turned up quite nice today, I know. Guys, I couldn't help myself. I got like loads of snacks. Like I got like some chocolate fingers, some Haribos, some digestives to go with my tea, because I'm becoming a tea babe. Like it's cold in the trenches. Like it's actually cold. I've got some Galaxy. Like I love snacking. Love snacking. So stocked up. This seems, oh, smashed. Oh no. Okay, so let's disregard this, but it's basically a salad bowl. It smashed, I think, during whilst it was getting, you know, transported. It probably smashed, but yeah, a salad bowl, which I don't eat salad, but it's a bowl. Well, it was a bowl. Guys, I got myself some liquid hand wash. This is actually what I use in my bathroom right now. It smells amazing. Absolutely love it. Ah! like I said, got some more cleaning products. We have some hand gel, we have some Dove, we have some fairy liquid, we have some bleach, fairy, like, boring adulting stuff. But this is baking soda. This is actually to use to clean. If you don't know, get to know. Guys, I actually got myself like a, what is this? A hot water bottle. Because when I tell you, this place is cold. It's not my room. Like, my room can get quite warm. This, don't mind this. Like, this is actually very childish. I just wanted the water bottle. And this is the only one they had, which was a unicorn one. Hey, I'm a unicorn. I'm different. But yeah, I basically got myself a hot water bottle because even when I used to live back home, feels so weird saying that, even when I used to live back home, I would always have one of these in my bed. So like, let's say for instance, I go out between 3 and 5 and I come back and I know it's going to be freezing cold, which normally it is because it's like dark by 4 p.m. I always put one of these in my bed, so when I'm coming home and I'm going to my bed, it's really warm. Another fairy liquid, some Mentos, because your breath can't be kicking. I'm sorry. Okay, so this is more uni related. I got 2 packs of Jenga. This is definitely not Jenga. I'm 2 packs of Connect 4 because, guys, you lot don't understand, yeah? Listen, these games nights, I am literally the games connoisseur. Like, I have pretty much every single game besides Monopoly and Cards Against Humanity, and even them, and they're being delivered Amazon Prime. Yeah, I need a Connect 4 because just when you want to do small, you know, get together with your roommates. I also got myself some microwave and fridge freezer wipes, which will be used for my microwave when it's my like time to clean it. We've got like a cleaning rotor here. English. I got some
I need to take it easy, otherwise I'm gonna lose it.
I got some Special K cereal because I heard that this is actually really, really good for you and gets you really energized and ready for the morning. So I got that. Let's go through this together. What I actually got was actually this wheelie bin. Guys, don't actually judge me, but this will actually be for my desk because I've noticed that on my desk, like so far, like as I've been just doing inductions at the moment, as I'm writing notes, I always put my paper in the bin when I can just separate it and kind of put it in here. So I've got like a little, is this extra? I've got a wheelie bin for my desk, okay? Okay. Again, snacks. Guys, I have to stock up on it. The best pasta ever. Like literally, I don't think anybody actually understands that this is the best pasta. Literally the best pasta ever. I don't think you know. So yeah, I got myself 2 packs of them because they were all out of stock when I went to Aldi and Lidl and most of the other stores. So get yourself the cherries, guys, because they'll have them in stock. Like I said, a part of adulting, another boring thing that you have to buy is liquid for your washing if you want your clothes to be clean. So I picked myself up some Persil. This is like £5 in the store, but I think online it was much cheaper. Oh, this smells so good. I can't wait to wash my clothes with that, which you'll probably see on my vlog channel, so go and head over there. More bleach, because you can never have enough bleach, because am I not cleaning my room? My bathroom, kitchen roll. I get through these quite a lot, so I picked up 2 of them. Oh, please, don't let me spray it, and then next thing you know, it's all over my camera. I missed the muscle, guys, for the bathroom. Okay, so, ooh, right, so guys, in this box, there's a lot of things that I just kind of stuffed in there, so we have razors, because girly stuff that I hate buying, you're probably thinking, Nana, why'd you get the gilet for men's ones? Because the men's razors are much better. I'm sorry, like when I shave with girls' razors, I'm sorry if this is TMI, but when I shave with girls' razors, I always end up having to shave again like a week after, and I mean like my armpits and my legs and stuff, like literally. So yeah, men's razors, the best. Some garlic paste, again, another ingredient I'll be using to cook with. If you want to actually see me use all these things in action, definitely go ahead and check just my vlog channel. I'll be cooking. It's a lit time, it's lols, it's banter, it's behind the scenes. Get to subscribing there. It was all kind of held in this little box, which I will be keeping all my snacks in, because in one of my cupboards that I have, I have like a designated place where I feel like I can put all my snacks and kind of keep this like my snack box. So if anybody's like, oh no, I can have a biscuit, I'll be like, oh, just grab the box. Guys, think about it. I feel like I picked up more stuff, but I got some tinfoil finally. Like, you don't understand how much I've been not wanting to buy tinfoil, so I bought 3 of them because, again, this will last me probably up until Christmas, maybe, we'll see. Some Kellogg's. They do white rice crisp, blah blah blah. They do white chocolate cocoa pops. Since when? But that was as brief as I could probably get that. I'm so sorry if this is quite a long-winded intro. If you want to kind of just, by now, if you've skipped to the room tour, I hope you did enjoy it. That's the stuff that I got from Cherries. Again, a huge shout out and thank you to Cherries. I'll leave all their links down below. Again, I will leave my discount code on screen here. JustLana20, make sure you go and shop there and get your groceries because they are stupidly cheap. Like, you could tell I literally bought everything in bulk because I don't want to buy it again because it's so cheap on the website. And yeah, if you've made it this far, make sure you subscribe, like the video if you did, and without further ado, let's get into the room tour. Yeah,
okay, so here we have it. This is the front door to my bedroom. This is my corridor. That is obviously the main door out, so don't mind me, I'm in my morning gown, and these are just my neighbors, and I am right at the end, and I have this stunning view from my kitchen. This is my kitchen, by the way, but we're not going to get too much into that. This is my door. It's huge. It's humongous. It's just open with a key card, but I've left it open. And this is what you see as soon as you walk in. Don't minus the bags because that is all for a haul video coming. But this is quickly, this is literally what you see as soon as you walk into my door. So starting from the back of my door, we have this over hook hanger thing I got from Wilkinson's. I showed it in my university hall. You guys would have seen this. And I've just used it to hang literally all my bags. I might change it up because I feel like it looks very, very messy because I've got different lengths of bags. And yes, I do have a lot of bags. I think bags just really change up an outfit. I've got three of my scarves there, which I will be religiously wearing throughout winter. But yeah, that is the back of my door. My door is actually quite big and very heavy. Then to the left of that, we just literally have my two lights. Well, two sets of lights because I have spotlights in my room, which are really nice at night. I have this thing, which I don't know what it does, but it's there. Actually, moving swiftly on, I have my radiator. I always leave my towel on here to dry. The radiator is really huge. I love it. It's really warm and it warms up my room very nicely. Then moving swiftly on, we have to the left of you my bathroom door. So we have a hook outside my bathroom door. When I say there's so many hooks in this room, right? So many hooks. There's even two hooks underneath all of that. So yeah, I will take you straight into my bathroom. And if you just open up like this, the door goes right the way around. If I just move my tripod out the way. The door opens really, really wide. So this is my bathroom. Hey, I have taken off my bonnet and changed and I'm in a dressing gown, but we move. Switch on here, and this is my bathroom, guys. I absolutely love my bathroom. It's like just such the perfect size for me, I personally think. And it just goes literally all the way around. So let's start off from the right of the bathroom, kind of make our way around to the shower. So we have my toilet. I literally have my little toilet scrubber thing from IKEA. We have two like flusher things for, I'm guessing, for a big poo. It's a wee, of course. Then literally we just have this little shelf platform thing, which I have put this little like coaster thing, which is for bathrooms, and I leave like my jewelry in here, like when I kind of forget to take off my jewelry and I'm about to hop in the shower. So I've just, as you can see, I've left some jewelry in there. We have a thing for shavers and stuff, which obviously I don't need. I have my Febreze, which literally smells amazing. I always tend to spray it after I finish up in here. I have my Ted Baker like wash bag thing, which has just currently got like my makeup brush thing. Like, I don't wear makeup, but it's just got like a few little makeup bits and like stuff like clippers and stuff and eyelash curler, like just random bits that I haven't found a home for yet, but it's just living there. And then we have, hello, this huge mirror, which is actually a cabinet. And up there, if you can see, I've got my hand sanitizers, which I got from Costco, which my mom bought me. So I'm stocked up for hand sanitizers. If you open this, literally, I've just stocked up full of cleaning products. I love this little setup here. Then moving swiftly down on, we just have some more cotton pads and some cotton buds because I bought two of everything because I really wanted to stock up. I just have all my like retainer stuff here, which I need to actually start using again because it's actually very bad. I stopped using it, but that is just my shelf so far. I mean, I'm sure it will accumulate with more stuff, but that's what I've kind of filled it up with. We have this full length mirror, like literally all the way down to the bottom, and I haven't actually really used this. I mean, I think I probably should do, but then moving swiftly on from that, we have again another like full rectangular, like literally this is all mirrored. It is kind of scary when I'm showering, but I love it. Then we just have this little panel thing, which I think was supposed to hold towels, but I just put my hand towel in here when I'm finished washing my hands and my face towel for when I'm finishing washing my face. Then we have my trolley. I absolutely love this trolley, guys. I don't think I would have showed you guys this in the hall, but this is the trolley that thankfully Frank and Daniel built for me. If you see my I think moving in vlog, you would have seen that there. But on the top here, let me just take a seat on the toilet so I can take you through what is in my trolley. On the top here, literally the purpose of this trolley is just to hold all these type of stuff that I know that I have and I know wouldn't find a home in my actual room. So on the top here we have some Sephora face washes, face masks, whatever it is, some Yes To ones. I've got another Sephora one. I've got cotton pads, I've got cotton buds, I've got hand creams, I've got whatever that is, I've got my skincare, I've got some more hand cream, I've got my Clean and Clear like skincare, then I've got like literally all like my toiletry stuff, some more skincare by the way, love St. Ives. So I've got like deodorant, baby oil, roll-on, and then over here we have more of the like mum things. So yeah, over here we have antiseptic wipes, washproof plasters, clear plasters, I don't know why I'm saying plasters, and then we just also have some wipes, which I'll probably pop one in my school bag once I actually, you know, I'm not doing school online. And then underneath that we've got literally hair products galore. I've got as many got to bees as you can see. It's kind of gotten messy, like it was very very organized, but it's kind of gotten messy, so I do need to clean that up. But I've got literally like my shampoo, conditioner, brushes, oils, just everything, gel, etc. Then on the last little trolley holder, I've got pads, I've got toothbrushes for my friends come to stay, I've got some soap, like I've just basically got everything you can think of, shaving stick, like literally everything you can think of and anything that you may need if you're a guest and you come to stay. Then I've got my little toilet roll thing that literally holds my toilet roll, and it's got like, that's where I keep it. Moving on to my sink, so we have, and by the way, if you're wondering, the trolley was from IKEA, £29. By the way, the theme for my room is grey and white, so you'll be seeing a lot of that throughout my room and little accents of it. My sink, moderate size, I do really like it. It's just like a mixer tap, so you can just kind of do that. And I really do like my sink. I have literally just bought, I bought this from The Range, which keeps my soap in it when I wash my hands. Got some mouthwash, toothpaste, toothbrush, the basics. Moving swiftly on, we have my shower. I love my shower. It is literally, the pressure of the shower is amazing, the like how hot it gets, because I like my showers steamy hot. And then it's really really big actually. I've just got my Dettol over there and my soap behind there, and then my little sponge there. Again, my shower is just absolutely humongous. I've got the little thing in the shower that prevents you from slipping and stuff, and the doors literally open and close like that. And Bob's your uncle. I'm not going to show you a one-on-one on how to use your shower, but that is my shower. And then I have my little memory foam like shower mat. Absolutely comfy. As soon as I step out of the shower and I get onto this, I'm literally so thankful that I bought this. Then I've just got my huge bin, and that is from IKEA. Yeah, but yeah, that is my bathroom. That took a lot longer than I thought, but yeah, that is my bathroom. And it's dark. I really do like my bathroom. Like, I think it's just the perfect size for me, and I think I just, yeah, I'm absolutely in love with it. So yeah, that's my bathroom. By the way, there's another hook, which I normally keep my dressing gown in there, but I'm obviously wearing it. But yeah, let me close that up. Then you move to the left. Just before we get to my bed, there's actually another plug socket. The one thing I loved about this room was that there were so many plug sockets. So literally, there's two plug sockets here. I've just popped an extension there, obviously off right now because I'm not using it. But just in case I ever needed it, I've just kind of kept that there. Then we move swiftly on to my bed, and I love my bed. A, because it's a double bed, and I haven't actually slept on a double bed before. Like, I don't think I've owned one before. I mean, literally in my house before this, you all know I was on a single bed, or slash one and a half, and before that I had sisters, so I was always like the single bed type of gal. So now I'm on a double bed, I'm absolutely living for it. And as you can tell, gray and white, that's the theme, that's the aesthetic. Again, I haven't fully completed my room, but I mean, it is what it is. This is my bed, absolutely comfy, love it. I am in love with how I decorated it. But let's actually get on to the dressing of the bed. So we have four pillows, two, you can see that. We have my gray pillows from IKEA, and this pillow was from The Range. Yes, I believe. that is my hot water bottle, which has literally been my best friend where it's been so cold. And then we have my DKNY throw, which is literally, when I say this has been an investment for $12.99, the softest thing ever. I have my TV remote because, as you can see, I have my TV. It's a 40-inch TV. It came with my bedroom and I do love it. But this is literally the comfiest place ever. Love it. And the fact that it's in the same position as my bed at home, like it's facing the window, it's on the left side of the room, absolutely love it. Hop onto the bed, you can see that there's so many sockets. So you've got two normal plug sockets, then you've actually got some USB sockets as well. And then from here, guys, this is actually what controls the light. So from my bed, I can actually control my main light. So if I wanted to switch one on or whatever. And this is just like a little light, which is very bright at night, but it's actually very good just to kind of have as a quote unquote bedside table lamp. Then if I just get actually properly onto my bed, we have a view of what you guys could kind of see from the kitchen. But we just have it from a more angled kind of point. Not everybody has this in their room, but because I'm at the end, like you saw how I was the end bedroom out of all my kind of flatmates, I have this stunning view and it's got blinds, which is really good because it projects more light into my room, which I do love. And I've just popped my IKEA like little fake plants all along there and just spread it out. I kind of kept here quite basic, as you can see. That might change depending on how I feel, we shall see. TV, it is a smart TV, so I can watch YouTube, Netflix, BBC iPlayer on it, and I have been loving it. Just underneath that, we have my laundry basket because I thought, why not just throw it there and I can just kind of throw in stuff like there if I really wanted to. If we just come underneath my bed, I actually do have under bed storage, which has been literally such a blessing. I have stuffed so many things in there because I did so much bulk shopping, like for like things like oil and like my blender, my rice cooker, like my fairy liquid and stuff like that. I literally just kind of keep all the things that I would not necessarily reach to or like really need on a day to day underneath there. And also that compartment there's also under bed storage, but you guys get the gist. See, we've got this little mat thing, rug thing. It does actually get dirty quite quickly, so I'm actually considering of getting a gray rug instead of this white one, but it was £7 and it was from IKEA and it is quite soft to stand on as soon as I kind of get out of my bed in the morning. Then we move from my bed more to this way, so we have my main window. I love the size of the window, I love how big it is, and it just does wonders. So if we start from kind of the bottom up, we have my basket, which is my basket I take down once I've kind of done my washing and I need to bring the wet clothes upstairs to hang on my dry rack. I kind of keep it in that. Then we have all this shopping which has accumulated. I promise you it looks like a lot, but it's not a lot. But that is ready for a haul video. Guys, you can take the girl out the hood, but you can't take the hood out the girl. This is exactly what I used to do all the time. I'd kind of leave all my stuff and parcels to pile up so that it's just a reminder for Nana to film the video. So literally, now that I've got this all here, I do need to get this filmed ASAP this week, and then all of this will kind of go away and this will be kind of clear and kind of bring some more space. But for now, it's here and saying film this video, Nana. Moving on to like my windowsill, she have all of like my wigs and my hair and like my extensions, I want to say. So I have my wig head, which I bought from Amazon, and I'm literally coming to actually revive this wig. I've washed it, but I just need to kind of like put it in hot water and kind of get the curls back to what it was again. So yeah, this wig head has actually been very useful like so far, and very practical. I have a ponytail, I've got another wig that I need to actually revamp, just trying to hide my dress, and then my bob wig behind there and my hairpiece. It's all a bit of a mare, but I mean, it's a sorted mess. That's what I call it. I also have blinds. I don't know if I mentioned that, but I do actually have blinds in my room, which is different towards me having curtains, but I don't mind it. And again, this is my window, absolutely huge. My window opens quite wide, which I love to let fresh air kind of always be in my room, just kind of wake me up as well. And this is my kind of view from my window. I'm not too high up, which I like. And that is the courtyard of my kind of accommodation, yeah. Okay, so moving swiftly on to the main part of my room. I'll say there's quite a few main parts of my room. Hey, you can see me in my mirror. But this is my desk. I absolutely love the thought of having a desk, the fact that I have a desk, I'm in love with it. My room was always so tiny back home, so I could never actually get a desk in there. But I don't even know where to start. I think I want to start kind of that way and then move my way up. Yeah, so underneath my desk, we have a Costco Kirkland pack of water. I haven't actually gone through that as quickly as I thought. I have an extension cord. And again, like I said, you guys, there's so many plug sockets in this room. I absolutely love it. We have my bin, which is actually filling up quite quickly. And then we have my little lap desk thing that I've just kind of put underneath my there because it takes up a bit of space. And then I just have some eggs, and that is just some food that I reach for but don't reach for, but it's not enough to go underneath my bed, but it's enough to kind of be put there. And then I have my Canon box for this camera I'm filming on now. Moving on to the actual kind of, you know, desk level where I kind of sit at. So we have on the left side of my desk, on the left side of my desk, we have this light, which actually is a light for my desk underneath it. Like it's built in, which is pretty sick. I have my personal assistant, which I reach for all the time. You can tell I always love to plan my week and kind of obviously just make sure I'm staying on task for everything. So that is literally what I use it for. I have my key card, I have my 2 liter water bottle because I am on a water diet. And then I just have a lot of kind of miscellaneous things. So I have like my folders, my notebooks and stuff like that, which I haven't actually started to use yet because we haven't actually started lectures yet. But yeah, I have just kind of put them in the like little magazine holders, and I feel like it just makes it look organized. Don't mind this mask, it's not actually supposed to be there, but you know. Then we have my little organizer thing, which I've put post-it notes, stapler, my AirPods, plug thing, Pritt sticks, Tippex, just things that I would reach for. My scissors has been such, like, so useful. I don't think anybody actually understands. A calculator, some just random stuff that I will use, like kind of reach for all the time. Then just behind my laptop, we have my pen pot, which literally has my highlighters, pencils, pens, whatever. I have a wheelie bin for my desk, which I got from Cherries, which you guys would have seen. And literally, I'm just gonna start putting paper in there, just kind of separate my rubbish. And then I just have this pen pot, which I've put my lip gloss, which shouldn't be there, but I've just kind of put it in there. And the thing I love about this desk is that it's kind of like the wires from underneath has that thing that just kind of goes through, so it makes it all neat. The things that are always plugged in is my lamp and my MacBook charger. Yeah, then I don't know if I've mentioned this, but the entirety of my backboard is completely corkboard, I think that's what it's called. But basically you can pin stuff on there. I've just kind of put two post-it notes, which is, that was something that we were attending like I think last week, but I should take this off now. And then this is something that is just kind of like a reminder that I need to complete my enrollment and do some stuff. And again, like I said, guys, this bin is actually quite handy. Moving on to the right side of my desk, we have, I mean, in the middle of it, we have my MacBook, which obviously has, see, your favorite YouTuber, her vlog channel. And, you know, she's just promo, guys. Go check out my vlog channel. Make sure you're subscribed because it is lit there. My MacBook is always on my desk and it's always kind of sat in this position if I'm not on my bed. So we have a few things over here. We have my lamp, which I absolutely love. It's been such a useful thing to me. I have some SD cards here just for when I'm editing and I want to reach out to them. My lamp is literally just a touch bar one, the one that I showed you, and you can change the color of it and you kind of make it dimmer, you can make it lighter. Amazing, from Amazon, £20, and it charges your phone. I have a picture of my parents, mama and pops, when they used to match. That's gang, man. I feel like it's just something sentimental. It kind of adds kind of like a homey feel to it, so I just kept that there. A water, because again, water diet. And then I just have my cellular device. I'll show you guys my Instagram because you should be following it if you're not. This is my Instagram. Make sure you are following it. Get me to 2,000 followers, guys. Like, that is the aim. That's my Instagram. Go and do that up. My content is, I think, is pretty great anyways. Then we also have my photography Instagram, which, guys, I am actually going to be relaunching very soon. So please go and support your girl. Make sure you're following my photography Instagram as well. I am kind of working quite hard just to kind of get content out on this page. Obviously, it is quite a lot harder because of COVID, but yeah, lip gloss. And we have this mirror. Hi. So this is the mirror that I use to kind of get ready with. It's nice, it's cute, it's quaint. It's the one from IKEA, and it's just slanted like this. And again, the best investment. I was actually gonna get like a mirror that had like the Hollywood lights around it, but I realized it probably wouldn't fit in here, and I wanna wait till second year to get that type of vibe. Yeah, so for now this will do. With the amount of lights I've got anyways, it's fine. This will do. I didn't even switch off this light. Then moving on to the right side, we have these drawers, and these drawers are super handy. In the first drawer, if I open it, you can see, well, my purse is there, which usually isn't in there, but we have all and everything stationery related. So these are the baskets that I bought from Wilko, and I've just kind of divided a few things up in there that I will need or may need. All of them are just kind of things I kind of reach for if I need it. And some of this stuff is actually for my pencil case, which I haven't obviously arranged yet because we haven't gone in yet or needed to go in because it's all been online. So yeah, this is just kind of all things and everything stationery. And I have a few games, so like obviously the blackjack that I showed you, well, playing cards. I have some Uno and I have another drinking game there just to kind of reach out for, and I just pop my purse in there because why not. But yeah, that's everything stationery related, and it's just kind of, it makes sense putting on the first drawer so I can just kind of reach out to it. In the second drawer we have everything technology related and everything kind of photography YouTube related. So I have things like camera chargers, external hard drives, USB-C ports, my camera, this is my Canon 1200D that I used to shoot with. I used to film with this, but I don't really like the lens on it, so I'm gonna save up and get another lens, because this is still a really good camera to start off with. We have an extra iPhone charger, guys. I always make sure I have a backup one. We have, I don't know, when I'm traveling, these type of things. We have so many different wires and like SD cards. I have my iPhone cases in here. I've got some batteries, like AA batteries. I've got portable chargers in here. We've got some more iPhone cases. Oh, I have another USB-C port. I bought two of them because you can never have like any more. And then I literally have like four SD cards underneath there as well, like brand new ones. Guys, I'm really stocked up. Like, I like the fact that I've got a lot of like equipment. Also got a film camera. Hey, hey. My technology stuff. And then in the last drawer, I just have underwear, socks, and bras, which I'm not really going to show you guys because it's a bit TMI. And moving swiftly on from my desk, we have this whole pan of kind of storage. So from the left side, from the right side, moving on to the left, we have this section, which is just for my Bibles, my devotionals, my notebooks, everything that I need to kind of just spend time with God, and everything that's kind of very, very important and like personal to me, I feel like. So I just kind of gave it this whole section to itself. So I have my life application Bible, my normal kind of KJV Bible, a Dake's annotated reference Bible, and my little Bible that I take out just kind of like evangelize, and it fits in my small bags. I have my anointing oil, my mantle. Then we have this. I've actually got this, which I write my notes in it, and it's actually got a scripture on. I got it from Amazon, guys. I absolutely love it. It doesn't look like it, but I just write loads of notes in there from service and stuff. This is a leather one that I got from TK Maxx, which I absolutely love. I have a prayer journal for women, which I need to actually start. I bought this at like the beginning of the year, so I think this is the best time to start. So yeah, all of this is like my section that I just love. It's very, very just, guys, make sure you're reading your Bible. Honestly, if you aren't, what are you doing? Like, honestly, what are you doing? But yeah, this is just that section that I've dedicated to that. And we just have like two things that are just randomly here. This is my little pot that just has broke, which I will start saving in. It just says broke, adjective, when you have money but it's not to spend. And that's just like literally there. I've always kept it there. This is again something from Terry's that I've just popped in my room. I still have to find a place for it to go. I might actually put it over there, but I'm not too sure yet. So yeah, that's its home for now. Then I just have two pictures of probably two of the most significant people in my life. So me and my dad when I was 2 months, I don't know how, 3 months old, I don't know how old I was. My Zara perfume, I want to actually start collecting perfumes. This one, the Zara one, absolutely banging. It's called Lily Pad and it smells so good. But yeah, the plan is to actually start collecting perfumes and kind of just display them here. Then I have my pastor. I absolutely love him. Like, this is just two of the most significant people in my life anyways, well, men in my life, besides obviously my mama. And yeah, this was on Zoom. We all had like a church Zoom, and obviously because it's COVID, so I just screenshot that and obviously just kind of popped it in a frame, as you can tell. And then moving on, we have my notepad. We got notepad. No, this is definitely not my notepad. Moving on, we have my scrapbook. If you've seen my vlog channel, you will know that I have actually made a scrapbook for 2020, and it's literally just filled with so, guys, it's filled with so many memories. It actually makes me want to kind of cry, like how much has happened this year, but it's still yet to be finished. So I'm just going to keep that there for now and obviously then kind of work through it. Kind of move upwards, we have my kind of the sprays. They're not my perfumes. These are just kind of sprays I kind of reach out for. We are four in a line. These are all Victoria's Secret, by the way. And this is just kind of like my room spray. Behind all of that, we have my Matalan little wicker baskets. And they just have random stuff in there. Like, that one literally just has all my headbands.
And then literally this one has like random, literally when I say random stuff, I say like, just miscellaneous things that you just don't know where to put. So I just put it all in there. And then on this side, we have my iPhone boxes and my AirPods case. Cause guys, like honestly, you need to keep them always. Everything literally just fits very nicely there. Then moving swiftly on, we have a few bags. So as I mentioned, all my bags are literally hung at the back of my door. However, I feel like these bags were very, very pretty, and all of them are pretty much brand new besides my Valentino bag, which I've worn. So we have two black ones, my Valentino one and my nice like little rectangle Primark one. We have another Primark one, which looks very, very bougie for Primark. And then we have another Primark one. And then I just have my like Louis Vuitton dupe little clutch bag. And then this bag was from Steve Madden, but it's from TK Maxx as well. And I just really like the colorway. I feel like it just looked really nice, all of it kind of like displayed there. Then we have my N. This is my N. This is my N that actually was supposed to light up but doesn't actually light up, so now it's just here for decoration. So this is just an N that doesn't light up. And then we have my huge wicker basket, which I got from Matalan because it came in a pack of three, and that just has like my blow dryer, some more headscarves, and then besides that we have all my tools. So we have like my Remington straightener, we have my hot comb, I think even my other straighteners up there somewhere. So yeah, this is just kind of like my hair tools section thing. Yeah, that is literally the top of my desk. I mean, it's not done, but it's done enough for me, I personally think. Also, by the way guys, I do also have this desk chair that actually came with the bedroom, with the accommodation. It's super comfy, it swivels, it's very comfy. You can make it higher, lower, shorter, whatever you want. And it again swivels, super, super comfy. I get all my work done on there and I absolutely love it. And then we move on to one of the last things in my room, and this is my wardrobe. My wardrobe is something that I definitely lucked out on. You guys know I have a lot of clothes. I love buying clothes. I have a clothes buying obsession, and the fact that it's literally built in from literally the ceiling down to the ground, I'm so blessed to be having such a huge wardrobe. So once you open it up, oh, guys, we have my fairy lights. So I actually saw this idea on Pinterest. I saw Anastasia Kings North do this with like more strip lights. These are just literally some fairy lights I bought from Primark and literally sellotaped. I don't know if you can see, but sellotaped them on just at the top. The rest is just literally dangling down. But at the top, I've just sellotaped it on just so that obviously it doesn't destroy the wardrobe and I don't get my deposit back. But my wardrobe is something that I've just recently sorted. Like, this was all a mess like literally like a couple of days ago. But up here we have my jackets. I've planned to just dedicate this hanging section just to hanging jackets, and like this is like a blazer co-ord. Just things that genuinely need to be hung will be hung, and it's obviously color coordinated. Yeah, these are from TK Maxx, by the way, some gray ones. Again, gray and white theme, gotta follow it through. Above that we have this shelf which literally holds all my tracksuits. In total I have about 9, and I have one more coming, so then 10. And they're not all just grey, there's some black ones behind that, and if you can see, but it is, if you see my tracksuit haul, then you would have seen all of these being tried on, so make sure you go check that out. Along this side we have pretty much most of my church clothes. It doesn't look like a lot, which I was thinking like, what happened to all my church clothes? So that has actually could really motivate me to just go out and buy some more church clothes. And then we just have a church jumper here as well. And then the first, so I have four. Nana, can I even count? I have four huge like shelvings, and I've just split up my clothes into this, and as you can tell, they're nowhere near full, guys. So everyone that said, Nana, you're taking too much clothes, yeah, tell me now if this is too much. Anywho, starting off with the top shelf, we have all my going out tops. So these are tops I would consider just kind of, if I want to throw on a nice top and jeans, these are kind of like the tops I would reach out for. Now, some of them are quite plain, so I do actually have all my checkered shirts behind that. If I just move my dresses out of the way so you can see. Oof, okay, cool. Yeah, so as you all know, I have a checkered shirt obsession. I literally have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I thought I had more than that, but I believe I have actually ordered some more. I love checkered shirts, and some of these checkered shirts go with these tops, so I just kind of thought, why not? Because again, going out section. Just on the kind of like top of going out, I have some going out dresses as well, mainly black, one gray and one khaki. And yeah, this is again just kind of for going out and stuff. If I want to look cute and maybe opt for a dress instead of a top and jeans, then we have that. Most of my clothes do have tags on, because when I tell you, it's actually a joke. Then moving down to the second kind of shelf thing, we have all my hoodies that aren't like tracksuits, so just kind of jumpers that aren't
like in a tracksuit set. So we've got like my Fila one, my Michigan one from Misguided. We have my Champion one from I bought in New York, from I think it was Urban Outfitters. I've got like my Wild Wild one from PLT, my Boohoo Man one. Like I've got quite a lot of like hoodies that just are good for styling, and I cannot wait to actually style them. Then I just have like my long Primark cardigan here. And we have literally all my graphic tees. These are my pride and joy. I absolutely love them. I definitely want to kind of get into definitely rocking them more. But yeah, these are all my graphic tees that I own. They doesn't, again, doesn't look like a lot, but I promise you there's more to the eye than you see. My jeans, guys, can we just deep? I actually don't have a lot of trousers, you know. Like it, maybe I don't know to you if this looks like a lot, but to me these aren't, this is really not enough. So these are literally my black jeans that I own, and I think two of them don't actually really fit me comfortably. These are my flare jeans, and then these are like my only actually pair of denim jeans that I have, and obviously I have a khaki pair, but I definitely need to do like a jeans haul or buy some like actually proper jeans and invest. Then this section is literally just pants. Then underneath here we have a lot of basics and just kind of home clothes and some belts that I don't know where to put, because again I don't really touch, well, and home clothes aren't something that I tend to kind of reach out for, so I just kind of put them at the bottom. And this is literally just, like I said, my lights are battery operated, so yeah. Then just down there we have my heels, my Jordans, and some sliders, which it looks messy, but to me it looks quite neat and didn't fit on my shoe rack. But that is my wardrobe. Absolutely love this fairy light like aesthetic. I feel like it does do a lot to the wardrobe. Then we have me. Hi guys, this is my mirror. This is where my full length mirror is. I like the fact that it's actually my wardrobe. I think it's something different. I think it's very different for a uni room, so this is where my outfit of the days are gonna be. Obviously my wardrobe are done. Absolutely love that place. Then we move onto the last part of my room. So this section is literally just full of tall things that just I didn't want to be in the way and just have found a home here. So we have my washing kind of what's this called, drying rack, which I again use at least every week. I have my ring light, which I'm yet to open. I have my tripod, which normally goes into this box. I have my Zara bag, which I didn't know where to put anywhere else, but it's just found its home here. Then I have just like my bag that I tend to kind of reach for. If it's not my Valentino bag, I tend to use this bag like on a day-to-day basis if I'm just like doing errands and stuff, again on another hook. And then we have my shoe rack. Y'all know your girl likes her trainers, so we got all my trainers. I'm gonna do a shoe collection anytime soon. I know a lot of you have been asking for it, but there's quite a few shoes I still want to do. But these are just, again, some of my trainers that I do own, and some of them are doubled up down there. And again, some of them are still in my wardrobe and under my bed, so we love to see it. But yeah, my shoe rack was from IKEA, yes, and it's just literally the perfect length. Like everything I've realized in my room is literally just the perfect size and perfect length that fits everywhere. And then I just have my broom and my dustpan and brush, because my room does get messy. And so yep, that's my dustpan and brush and broom, which I just kind of kept in my room. And I literally have a doorstop, which just in case I want to kind of go in and out my room, I have that there. And we are back to where we started, guys. We've literally done a 360 of my room. I absolutely love. I know it is bigger than the normal uni room, but I am absolutely in love with it. I love where everything goes. I love how everything looks, and I'm really happy with it. Honestly, I love my room. And just like that, guys, that is the end of the video. I actually couldn't find the file where I had filmed the outro, so this is the outro, guys. Make sure you hit the like button if you did enjoy this video. I do apologize, it was slightly long-winded and very in-depth, but you guys requested the room tour. Subscribe if you're new to my channel. Again, get me to 15,000 subscribers, and I'll see you guys all in my next one. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye.